Welcome to our channel. So today in this video we'll be sharing you Siemens Java interview questions for experience, and this video is shared by one of our subscriber friend. So if you are looking out for the questions that are being asked at Siemens, then this video will definitely help you out. And we are also, like, the subscriber friend has also shared the answers as well, so it will definitely benefit you. So firstly let us see the mail that we have received from Shubham. So Siemens Java interview questions. Hi team, this is Shubham, one of your subscribers. You are doing great job, so I have also wanted to contribute. Interview with Siemens, experience is for 4, 2 technical rounds and one manager round happened. Attachment contains the interview question and answers asked in the first round of the interview. Very soon we'll be sending the second round and manager round interview questions as well. Please upload this. It took a lot of time to type the questions and type the question and answer. Note, the first round coding questions were very simple, so didn't share. Please hide my email ID. Okay. So this was the mail. So before getting into the questions part, let us talk about two problems that a lot of our subscriber friends face. One, how to get interview calls as a fresher, and two, stuck with small companies. And coming to the freshers, see, jobs are very hard to come by because of COVID currently. And secondly, many times candidates miss out a job opportunity because they don't have a better degree or had a poor network. So these are the two reasons that freshers are not getting jobs these days. And second one, stuck with small companies. So here we found a solution for these two problems, and that solution is one platform called Relevel. Let's quickly visit that platform and see what it is offering for us. So this is the platform, guys, Relevel. So Relevel is India's first hiring torment platform. It is really helpful for freshers and early stage career individuals, as it has more than 500 plus positions plus 50 plus companies already associated with it currently. And believe me, this number is going to shoot up very soon. Here, even as a fresher and even being from a very small college, you can get a package up to 15 plus lakhs per annum. It just completely pure your based on your pure talent and skills, which will be considered here. And if you can scroll down and see, you can have the list of company names that are already associated with this platform. So you can see Razorpay, Urban Company, Upgrad, WebEngage, and lot of things, 5paisa, and lot many other companies are there. So how to apply? So here you can see there are 3 popular tournaments, that is business development, front-end development, back-end development. So according to your will, according to your choice, you can register in any one of the tournament, and you can apply our coupon code which is there in the description to get 10% extra discount here. And very important thing here is the registration closes on 22nd June 2021, and the tournament begins on 26th June 2021. And few important things that I would like to share here: the tournament is not related to, like, restricted to BE, BTech or MBA. Anyone can register and participate in the tournament, and the investment, that is 1799 after coupon is applied, will be the best investment of your life. There are 3 tournaments as you can see, and in each tournament there will be 2 rounds. One will be prelims and other is mains. And upon clearing the mains, you will be getting a mentoring session. This is very important, that you will be getting a mentoring sessions from the Relevel team to help you with clearing the company interviews. So what are you waiting for? Register, participate in the tournament and get the offer. So coming to the first question: how locking mechanism is implemented by JVM? So the answer is, this answer was shared by our subscriber friend itself. The implementation of locking mechanism in Java is specific to the instruction set of Java platform. For example, with Java, with x86, it might use the CMP, XCSG, atomic, compare and exchange at the lowest levels to implement the fast path of the lock. The CMP, XCSG instruction is compare and swap instruction that guarantees atomic memory access to the hardware level. If the thread cannot acquire the lock immediately, then it could spin lock or it could perform a syscall to schedule a different thread. Different strategies are used depending upon the platform JVM switches. So this was about the first question. Coming to the second, which event bus is used by Saga pattern? So when we use event based communication, a microservice publishes an event when something notable happens, such as when it updates a business entity or anything. Other microservices subscribe to those events. When the microservice receives an event, it can update its own business entity, which might lead to more events being published. This publish subscribe system is usually performed by using an implementation of event bus. The event bus is designed as an interface with an API needed to subscribe and unsubscribe to events to publish the event. The implementation of this event bus can be a message queue like RabbitMQ or service bus like Azure Service Bus. This was about the second question, event bus. Third question, why should we use Threadpool executor when we have executor framework? So here is the source code of executor.new-fixed-threadpool. That is, you can see the code. It will return Threadpool executor threads, and it is using linked block queue. So this method uses Threadpool executor class, which uses default configuration as seen in the above code. Now there are scenarios where default configuration is not suitable. Say instead of linked blocking queue, a priority queue needs to be used, etc. There can be any scenarios. In such cases, caller can directly work on the underlying Threadpool executor by instantiating it and passing the desired configuration to it. So this was about Threadpool executor. Coming to the next question, what is the difference between address Spring Boot application and address enable auto configuration? Following are the differences between address Spring Boot application and address enable auto configuration. Availability. Coming to availability, Spring Boot application was introduced in version 1.2, while address enable auto configuration was introduced in 1.0. Purpose. Enable auto configuration enables auto configuration feature of Spring Boot application, which automatically configures things if certain classes are present in class path. Example, it can configure themeleaf template resolver and view resolver if themeleaf is present in the class path. On the other hand, address Spring Boot application does three things. It allows us to run the main class as a jar with the embedded container like web server Tomcat. It enables Java configuration. It enables component scanning. So this was the differences between Spring Boot application and address enable auto configuration. What happens when we call Spring Boot application dot run method in main class of Spring Boot application? So syntax of the class containing main method looks like below. At the rate Spring Boot application will be annotated at the class level, and in the public static void main method, we just write one line, return Spring Boot application dot run the application dot class and argument. When we run this class as a Java application, then our application gets started. A Spring application dot run is a static method, and it returns an object configurable application context. Configurable application context, like, it is similar to equals to Spring Boot Spring application dot run. So Spring container gets started once run method gets called. Spring container once started is responsible for creating all the objects. This is done by direct component scan. Remember, at direct Spring Boot application is a combination of at direct component scan plus direct configuration plus at direct enable auto configuration. Then dependency injections happens and manages the life cycle of all the beans will happen. So these are the answers that were given by our subscriber friend itself. These are not our answers, own answer. What is the difference between map and flat map? So map transforms the element into something else. It accepts a function to apply to each element and returns a new stream of values written by the passed function. It takes function object as a parameter. Example, function tall function, tall double function, too long function. Flat map, combination of map and flat operation. So we apply map operation on each element and then flattens the result. So if function used by map is returning a single value, then map is okay. But if a function used by map operation is returning a stream of list or stream of string, then we go for flat map to get the stream of value. So these are the differences between map and flat map. Next question, what is the boxed string? So if you want to convert stream of objects to collection, we go with list of stream, how are you now, dot collect, collectors dot tools. The same process doesn't work on stream of primitive. However, like to convert the stream of primitives, we must first box the elements in the wrapper classes and then collect them. This is type of stream is called box stream. Example of is given here. So in stream of 12345 dot box dot collect to list, then output will be a list of numbers. To be honest, even I was not aware of this, what is box stream. So just came to know this. List Spring Core and stereotype annotations. So Spring Core annotations are qualified unaware, configuration, component, scan, required, bean, lazy, value, and Spring stereotype or component controller service and repository. What is the difference between controller and rest controller? So controller creates a map of model objects and finds a view for that. Rest controller simply returns the object, and object data is directly written into HTTP response as JSON or XML. Basically, @rest_controller equal to @controller @response_body. @rest_controller was added in Spring 4. Next question: why Spring introduced @rest_controller when this job could be done by using @controller and @response_body? The functioning or output of @controller and @response_body is the default behavior of RESTful web services. That's why Spring introduced @rest_controller, which combined the behavior of both @controller and @response_body. Next question, tell me something about Swagger tools which you have used. So Swagger editor can edit open API specifications, Swagger UI, collection of HTML, CSS, JavaScript assets that dynamically generate beautiful documentation, Swagger code gen allows generation of API client libraries, Swagger parser, Swagger core, Swagger inspector, Swagger hub. Everything has its own answers. Next question is, what application server have you used and what are the benefits of that? So I have used WebLogic application server. WebLogic server provides various functionalities. WebLogic server provides support for access protocols like HTTP, SOAP, etc. It also provides data access and persistence from database server. It also supports SQL transaction for data integrity. It also provides security. So when we use WebLogic server, we do not have to care about protocol security. Protocol or security, database transaction, data integrity, etc. So all these are handled by WebLogic server. You can focus on business logics. Just, is there any speed increase while indexing a table, and will indexing every column defeat the purpose of indexing? Indexing any table, either memory or file system based, will speed up the queries that select or sort results based on that column. This is because the index works like a tree structure, and the search distance depends upon the depth of the tree, which increases a lot slower than the row count of the column. Indexing every column doesn't defeat the purpose of index, but it will slow up inserts and updates because those changes will cause an update of every index of the table. Also, the indexes takes up space on the database server. So these were the questions that were shared, and thank you for watching. Very soon we hope we'll be updating the second part of the video as well. And thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed us, please do subscribe. Thank you.